In Denmark, there is huge potential for agricultural biomass production and green biorefining, which can be used to produce animal feed, textiles, building materials, biochar, fertilizer and food, and which also has several climate and environmental advantages. Every year we consume 2.7 million tonnes of protein in Denmark, and over 1 million tonnes of this protein is imported, mainly soya from South America and the USA. By increasing our domestic agricultural biomass production and green biorefining capacity, we can begin to rely less heavily on imports. The Green Biorefining Technologies Group at Aarhus University separate fresh green biomass into protein products, a fibre pulp and a residual liquid known as brown juice.
Behind me we see a worldwide unique research facility, the Green Biorefinery Demonstration Platform at Aarhus University here in Viborg. Since the inauguration in 2019, we have tested and optimized the use of green plants from agriculture such as grass, clover, alfalfa and catch crops, plants from the sea and more exotic bioresources from abroad. We process and transform these green plants into usable and desired products for a more sustainable and biobased society. The products include protein products for feed and food, biomaterials, bioenergy and biofertilizers. In the outside part of the demo platform, we fractionate the green biomass into a juice fraction and a fibrous press cake.
The demonstration platform can process between 3 and 10 tons of biomass per hour. It is a flexible processing platform and is continuously optimized and innovated to suit the research project it's being used for. It delivers data and state-of-the-art results within the technology of green biorefining, with a focus on scalability and technology implementation. The fresh biomass goes through a maceration process before it is pressed. At the facility, we test, compare and optimize different maceration and pressing technologies. We can cut and shred the freshly harvested biomass and mix the biomass into a liquid process stream, which is macerated in equipment types fit for pumpable slurries and separated in a two-step dewatering and pressing process. The fibre pulp is then assessed according to its protein content so that it can be used for ruminant feed, biomaterials or bioenergy.
Through technology development, integration and upscaling, we aim to create positive business cases where we produce multiple products from the same raw material. Here in the indoor part of the biorefinery demo platform, we have a flexible setup of process technologies to treat the green juice coming in from the outside to separate protein products and a liquid residue full of sugars and inorganic nutrients.
The protein separation of the green juice happens in the processing hall by precipitating the proteins chemically, biologically or thermally, and separating the protein products using centrifugation or membrane technologies. This produces a protein concentrate and a brown juice. The protein product can be extracted in several qualities and used in different food and feed applications. The basic process using thermal precipitation produces a protein concentrate with 50 to 60% crude protein and has been proved to successfully substitute a soy meal for monogastric animals. The process is being improved and developed so that it can also produce protein isolates for food products. The brown juice contains soluble organic compounds as well as inorganic nutrients and can be readily used for biogas production, fermentation media and fertilizer products.
Here in the lab, we analyze and monitor the content and quality of all process streams from the demo platform, from the raw biomass input to the product outputs. We do this to get a better understanding of what is happening when we treat different types of green biomass with different types of technologies and to optimize product quality. In this way, we can create better solutions for commercial implementations.
All tests and development trials on the demonstration platform are thoroughly monitored through inline process data and sample analysis in the laboratory. The production and consumption system of the future will be circular and based on renewable feedstocks, integrated green biorefineries will play a vital role in the circular bioeconomy, optimizing and innovating the use of perennial green bioresources and reducing environmental impact.